Tulsa, Oklahoma, home to the Tulsa Golden Hurricane and Skelly Field, where the fans have gathered and they are ready to see those Hurricanes gather some strength. We're really looking forward to this matchup. You've got a team that's made its way into the top 25, now trying to pass an all-important road test. As we'll see, the number 20 team in the country, the Louisville Cardinals, taking on a team from the AAC, the Tulsa Golden Hurricane. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth by David Pollock and Jesse Palmer. And guys, let's get this thing started. Tulsa will kick off and we'll get this game started. Looking for blockers. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Cardinals offense will get the first possession of the game. And here he is, guys. Anytime he takes the field, he is in complete control of this offense.
And David, he gives defensive coordinators nightmares because of his ability. They're going to have a hard time slowing him down.
No, he just doesn't have those weaknesses, those flaws. The whole playbook available, and he is a dude.
And that's a really nice play. It's impressive. When it's first down and the defense thinks you might be running the football, you still can line up. You can get some movement at the point of attack and find a little crease for your team.
A collision, and he stopped at the 27 after picking up one.
Yeah, and the running back didn't get much here, but, you know, you clearly want to always establish the tempo, run the football, be consistent, make that defense physically meet the challenge.
Third down, and they'll need five to keep this opening drive moving. On the move, he fires. And they can't make the connection on third down. The Cardinals will call on their punt team. Not going to risk a return here. He'll make the fair catch. So Tulsa's offense has its first opportunity of the day. And they seem to believe that they can take big plays away and man coverage by just locking him up in this matchup, David.
Yeah, and it's hard to lock down a great wide receiver, but a great defensive back versus a great wide receiver, we got a showdown.
Yeah, let's be honest, David. Most defenses don't have a dude like that at cornerback that could do that in a game like this, but this matchup is unique, and it's going to really determine the outcome of the game.
They'll ride the hot hand. Still on his feet at the 45. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. They'll leave it with him. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
We're trying to run the ball on first down, guys, but just nothing doing up front. Their offensive line got blown up on that play. There was nowhere for that guy to go.
Trying to surprise him with the pass. Grabbed in the middle, it's Presley. They make the stop after the catch and still some work to do to pick up that first down. Third down coming up after that completion. From the gun, wants to pass. He makes the connection. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep him from getting the first down. Tulsa comes to the line with a first and 10. On the run, it's Watkins. After the pickup of 9, it's 2nd and 1.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
From the gun, the ground game. He'll be down at the 4-yard line after that terrific run.
Man, who says you can't run up the middle anymore, right? Everybody thinks, I got to make big plays, I got to go way out to the left, way out to the right, way out in space. Nope, right down the middle, nice blocking. How about the running back? You could tell the speed, the wheels, does a great job getting down the field, making a huge rushing play.
They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Yeah, what a great job by the defense. You got to understand, it's physical time, right? They want to run the football when they start getting inside the 5. Nice job getting penetration, getting the tackle for the loss.
Going for 6. And it's caught! Touchdown, Tulsa!
And it's so underrated, the relationship between a QB and a wide receiver.
And it's blocked! A 67-yard touchdown drive there. And the score comes on a 5-yard touchdown pass. on the run from inside his own five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. Boy, three and out last time, Davey. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm, got off the field really.
Afterburner's coming. And there was lots of space as he gets it to the 39-yard line. That kind of play will send a surge of energy through your offense. Now they've got it first and 10 inside the 40. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. That linebacker was a heat-seeking missile, and the heat that he sought was the ball carrier.
Yeah, great job, great feel. Linebackers are making all the calls in the defense and understanding when I need to come through that gap and come through with bad intention. Those guys are usually 245 pounds of heat-seeking missile.
They started this drive with a big play, but now they need a conversion to keep it alive on third down. What a nifty run there to pick up the first down.
All right, well, look, I know the defense was feeling real good about their run D coming into this one and how they've been playing up to this point, but finally, David, the offense breaks through and they finally generate something positive on the ground.
And I can't tell you how easy it is. When you're going to throw the ball consistently, and I know it, I'm going to pin my ears back and I'm going to get to the quarterback. It makes life really easy on the defensive line. But when you can have balance, now the defense doesn't know what's coming. They need more of this if they're going to be successful on offense.
He'll get that one all the way down to the 4-yard line before he stopped.
It's so nice as an offense to know you can generate explosive plays by handing the football off to this guy. He has gotten incredible.
And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Cardinals. They'll try to tack one more on their score.
And what a push up front by this offensive line. Everyone playing in unison, driving out of their stance, working into the second level, hats on hats, creating a lane for that running back.
Fielded in the end zone, it's Benjamin. Not nearly as much as he had hoped when he brought it out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the 15. The Golden Hurricane offense comes back onto the field. Jesse, a very productive drive last time, wound up with a touchdown.
Yeah, mixing and matching play calling really well. Nice balance on that last one, Dave. Let's see what they can do here in this next drive.
Yeah, and I don't expect anything different. When you put together a drive like that, I would do more of the same. Keep the pace, keep it going.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. They go to the counter. Knocked down at the 26 after ripping off 10 there.
That has got to be demoralizing if you're on defense because they just ran the ball right up the middle, down your throat, and they gashed you.
They'll run it out of the shotgun. And he's a real nowhere man tackled in this no-gain land. Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. They'll try the run. And after the stop, that is going to put a bow on this first quarter. Here on third down. How about these two running games so far? Dominance on the ground as we look at the first quarter stats. They've swapped ends of the field, and we're ready to go in the second. A third down play to get the quarter started. Movement here from the tight end. They'll try to run for it. Works his way to the 41, and that is plenty to give him a first down. Tulsa seems to have the whole playbook working. Moving the running back, trying to get the D to tip its hand. Grab behind the line. It's Watkins. At the 40, there he goes. Oh, and the defense in chase mode, and they finally get him down at the 35. They've done a really good job identifying mismatches, and they find one out of the backfield there.
Reese, I really don't think it's that hard. My guy is better than yours. Find the matchup across the field. Running back's got some speed. Get it in his hands quickly. Throw it to him fast. Let him make somebody miss against a slower guy that's usually a linebacker.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. From the gun, the running back tries to hit the hole. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made. Third and short from the 26. Pretty easy field goal range, but they'd love to pick up the first. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down. Tulsa comes to the line with a first and 10. They're going to ride this running back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. This drive facing a little adversity on second and 11. The give to the back. They wrestle him down after he picks up six inside the 20 and down at the 18.
It's going to be important this offensive line is able to get a little bit of push. Just got to give this guy an inch, a little crease, and he can make yards for it.
Oh, he dropped the football. He had it right in the middle of the field and just ran before he finished the catch. It'll be fourth down. So now on comes the field goal unit. Field goal is good. And with that field goal, they now have the lead. After putting up a three spot, the kickoff unit set to go. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Couldn't find a way to create that broken field as he stopped at the 25. Louisville has it back in the offense, coming out ready to attack. Jesse looking to take it down the field for back-to-back touchdowns.
I think it's really important for them moving forward, too, to have a lot of balance, right? You want to be able to keep this defense guessing.
Yeah, and you got me searching for answers after that last drive. You stack another drive on top of this, their defense's heads are going to be spinning all over the place.
Ball's at the 29. Defense can taste getting off the field. It's third and long. Looking downfield, it's shut. And it's incomplete on third down.
And on that third down play, there just wasn't any timing between the quarterback and his intended target. As a result, ball falls incomplete, setting up fourth.
They're throwing for it on fourth down. Complete, out of the backfield, looking for the sticks. And they wrap him up, but not before he's got enough for the first down. Really good job there. Don't force anything. Take your time. And he finds his man for the first down.
Yeah, and I think really good job by seeing the defense. Understand that they're dropping back. They're taking away most things. All right, get the ball to my running back. He can make plays after he catches it. Nice job by the quarterback seeing the situation and where to go with the football.
And this senior quarterback a little too bold there, and he's lucky he didn't get picked off throwing into double coverage.
I think we got a little bit sloppy on that route. You need more separation if you're going to give your quarterback a better target trying to complete that in play.
Here they come, facing third and long from the 40. Makes the grab down the middle. And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down. A couple of yards shy of the first down marker, but they've decided this is four down territory. The offense still on the field. They'll get the first down. It's spotted on the 49. After picking up a couple of first downs already on this drive, they'll snap it from close to midfield. And how about the efficiency on that one? It'll bring up second and four. We've reached the two-minute warning, and we have ourselves a ball game, and they have a chance to take the lead here before the half. Six-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and four. He's looking to throw. Good timing on the quick out. They knock him down at the 40, but he picks up five, and it'll be enough for a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Quarterback strolling away from heat. On the move at the 30. He's finally stopped, but a big play there with his feet as he moves those sticks. It's now first and 10 from the 24-yard line. He's looking to throw it. Got it in the middle, it's Brooks. He is tackled, but it'll be a fresh set of downs. It's first down from the 11. He wants to throw. Dances away from the pressure, going to his left. And the quarterback caught up to and sacked at the 12. Operating in the red zone here on second down. To the air, it's shut. Makes the grab. They'll mark him down at the 2. The excellent execution on that throw and catch. Tight quarters deep in the red zone, but they can pick up a first down without scoring. Third down. They'll try to move the chains on the ground. That just never had a chance as they controlled the middle of the field and stopped him in the backfield on third down. Now on fourth down, here comes the field goal team. Oh, and the attempt is no good. Still down by two. Chance to take the lead out the window, guys. Tough break there. The short hands, it's Benjamin. And a good job of coverage by that defense, just a short pickup. Now on second down. He's looking to throw. He's got his man. He's brought down quickly. Minimal gain there, still a bit short of the first down. This is where you make the money on the drive. Ball at the 30, it's third and short. And that's incomplete. A defender all over him. Knocked the ball to the ground. Fourth down coming up. Tulsa will be forced to send out the punt team. Running it back, it's Lacy. Tries to find a little more running room on that return, but he'll be stopped at the 36. The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. In modern college football, Jesse, if there's time, there's an opportunity to attack.
And I like them being aggressive here too, guys. Look, they practiced this all week long. Now you're in that situation to go out there, have some fun, and let it fly.
And defenses are taught to stay deep, play prevent in these situations. So I think you could get a good chunk play and then possibly get a field goal to tack on before the half.
Tip ball put it up for grabs, and I thought he had it, but somehow it slithered through his fingers.
Yeah, that was a good play on the ball, getting his hand up and getting the tip, getting the deflection. Ball bounces up in the air, falls to the ground, incomplete pass.
Throws to the wideout. The pass falls incomplete, and there are 8 seconds left. Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. Back to pass, it's Shuck. Fires to the middle. It's complete. What a nice connection. Knocked down immediately, and they've got it at the 25. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer. And with just a few seconds remaining here in the first half, they'll try to kick a field goal. He got it. And the field goal to end the half takes us to halftime. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
All right, guys, a delightful first two quarters today from gorgeous Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. And with that, let's head back to the guys inside H.A. Chapman Stadium.
And the Cardinals will kick it off to start the second half. And he'll just take a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. We'll get another look at this Tulsa offense. Tight game as we start the third quarter, and we'll see what type of adjustments they made at halftime.
And getting the ball first here, I think, is such a big deal. Like, I get the first chance to make a statement, to make the adjustments, to create some momentum for my squad right here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I think it's so important for this offense to set the tone here early in the second half, to get a nice drive going, build that confidence, and get your defense ready to come on out, get a stop, and change the complexity of this game.
Probably the toughest call on the play sheet. Third and long. Ball's at the 25. And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17. Tulsa will be forced to send out the punt team. Three and out, and not much choice but to get rid of the ball. That's usually prime return position, but he'll make the fair catch just outside the 40. First down for this offense. Running to the left. He showed it all there. A little elusiveness, a little power, and he's got the first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. They're going to go right back to him on first down. After the pickup of 9, it's 2nd and 1.
Coaches always harp about staying ahead of the chains, and when you can run with that type of efficiency on first down, man, you are doing just that.
Hand off from the gun. Finally pulled down, but not before moving the chains for a first down.
You know, you start day one of training camp running your base runs. You need a few yards, you run these plays. You need a first down, you run these plays. You rep them over and over and over again. They're not sexy, they're not pretty, but in the end, they're effective, and they get you that new set of downs when you need them.
Last play was a near disaster, now dealing with 2nd and 13. Gives it to the back on the draw. Squeezes out a couple of yards down to the 32.
This offensive line better figure out a plan for this deep tackle. He is tough to block with one guy. You might want to start double-teaming him. He's going to be a problem moving forward. You saw all of his ability on that last play.
Catch in the middle. It's Johnson. And it is a chunk play. A huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end.
Well, offensive coordinators put in countless hours every week trying to formate and use different personnel groupings and shifts and motions to give their offense success on third down. You can tell in this game, this offensive coordinator, he has put in the work this week.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Well, I know this is an offensive line that has a ton of pride, and they want to come out each and every game and really impose their will on the D-line. They got just enough push there on that run play to pick up the first.
Looking for just one more yard. It's 2nd and goal. Tries again to get it in. Just hammer it with this running back again, and he noses his way into the end zone. And they kick it through for the extra point, and they have an 8-point lead. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it out. It's Benjamin. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he stopped at the 14. The Golden Hurricane offense comes back onto the field. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
The last drive, that 3 and out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot, and you got...
And it's intercepted! A turnover for the defense. They got him down pretty quickly, but they're set up now at the 21-yard line. Short fields make successful offenses just what they want here. They'll try the right side. Pulled down after a pickup of 6, but he gets it inside the red zone. It's down at the 15. Got 6 on first down. Now a lot of options on 2nd and 4. The lone back's got it. Brought to the ground, but not before getting enough for the first down.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
They've pushed it ahead to the 4. They'll try to cash in on 2nd and goal. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. They get him on the ground at the 3-yard line, but this defense is taking some punches. They love to make this short field pay off with a touchdown instead of a field goal, but it into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, Cardinals! A quick strike, just as we expected.
And quick strikes are easy when you got such great field position. Obviously, when the offense starts in such a good spot, puts the defense in a bad position, and the offense takes advantage.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. And they desperately wanted to attempt a return, but decided not to. Instead, they'll take the touchback. We'll get another look at this Tulsa offense. Well, let's see if this drive goes better than the last one. They were in and out quickly after the quick pick, David.
Yeah, first play, big mistake, man. Now, let's get this offense in a little bit of a rhythm. Maybe before you open it up again, Palmer, or do you trust him right away?
He seems to me like the guy maybe that just needs to kind of get into the flow of the game. So maybe you get...
He's loose, and they're getting it rolling with that play to the 42-yard line. And now on first down after converting with the run.
Well, the defense knew coming into this one, Reese, that this team was going to try to use their speed and take advantage of it, and they did right there. Nice gain on the run play to the right.
Found plenty of running room in that defense. They've got to find a way to get there and make the tackle in the open field.
Yeah, and they got to do a good job with their eyes, finding the football. They've got to get a lot of bodies to this guy because he is fast.
Got eight on first down, now looking at a second and two. Wrestled to the ground after picking up the first down.
Pounding. I might not have that pretty run-pass ratio of 50-50, but if I can run the football like this consistently, if you're not going to do anything about it, you want to be a great offensive coordinator, keep calling the run.
And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage. If you like old-school running games, this has been the game for you and a couple of guys who starred through the first three periods. One more quarter to play, and it might be unlikely, but hey, it's college football. Comebacks happen. We'll get this quarter going with a second down play. After run, now throw. And the defense gets home and makes a play at the 37-yard line. This is a third and long. Looking downfield, and he needs a bunch. And the defense gets loose, bringing the heat, and down he goes again. Down by multiple possessions, they can't come up empty on this drive in the fourth quarter. They'll go for it on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. And it's incomplete. The long pass on fourth down is to no avail. Louisville has it back in the offense, coming out ready to attack. Line gets set, first down. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. And they try the middle of this defense, and that is not happening. They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. The give out of the gun. Nice gain of six, leaving them with third and four.
Man, he's done everything for this offense today, running the football, so much so that he's now got 98 yards rushing. We're in the fourth quarter. One more carry, and this guy could eclipse the 100-yard mark.
In the dead center of the field as they try to convert this third and short. Still running at the 40. Third down conversions are huge, and they've got one, and they're at the 35. The Cardinals will line it up on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground to keep this clock moving. They knock him down inside the 30 at the 29. It's a pickup of six. 6-yard pickup on first down leaves him with second and four. To the ground with the back. Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks with a first down.
I think you have to like what you see if you're the coaching staff here. Your offense is on the field, and it looks like you got a pretty good drive going, and you're just going to try and keep this thing marching, keep the clock ticking. You've got a really nice lead here late. Just want to find ways to keep the chains moving. They're doing.
Touchdown, Louisville! And the route is on. PAT unit on the field. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And the capper, a 19-yard toss for the touchdown. And no chance at a return here. They'll start this drive at their own 25. The Golden Hurricane offense comes back onto the field. That last drive was promising at times, but stalled out, and they turned it over on downs, Jesse.
I think they got to do a better job here, just being better early in the downs, on first down, finding positive.
Yeah, and it's frustrating when you move the football and get stopped on the other side of the field and get no points, but they've had some success, and I like the aggressiveness. They just got to cash some of these drives in.
Really short gain on that one. Defense all over it. Tulsa wasting no time. Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. Nice defensive play to get a hand in there and knock it away.
And it's just been that kind of day for this quarterback and this offense, guys. They have never been able to get into a rhythm throwing the football. Timing's been off. Accuracy hasn't been great. We've seen some drops. Just not in sync.
He's running free down the middle. The 10. Touchdown, Golden Hurricane. And once he found open space, the band might as well start playing. Getting aggressive here and going for two.
Really nice job seeing the middle of the field, seeing I can go deep and attack the middle of the field. And you can tell he runs a post, balls right on him, catches the football, and then gets to gallop right into the end zone for a touchdown.
They are running out of time here. They need to get the ball back. They'll line up for the onside kick. That's why they call them the hands team. They're able to secure the onside kick. The Louisville offense is headed back out on the field. This has been exactly the way you draw things up, David. The offense has really been moving the football.
And it's been great execution. They've done exactly what they've wanted to do. Build the lead. Now Palmer's a different animal. Now you got to protect it.
You can tell they were paying attention in practice this week in the film room because they have gone out everybody right now on the same page.
They get him stopped after a pickup of 5 to the 28. It's third down now. They ought to be able to get off one more play before the two-minute warning. He's brought down, but not before they pick up the big first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. From the gun, he leaves it with the back. Relentless, tough running gets it down to the 4. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. On second down, let's see if they go right back to the run and put this game on ice. Single back formation, and they give it to him. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. The clock will stop with this timeout from the offense. They'll get a chance to regroup on the sideline. Looking for room. It's Turner. And there were some collisions in there. The D finally stops him short of the marker. Now on fourth down, they'll try to come away with 3. It's good. And now the lead is even bigger. They're really starting to extend that lead as they get ready to kick it away again. And it'll be a touchback. The ball will come out to the 25-yard line. We'll get another look at this Tulsa offense. This offense has pretty much been stuck in the mud the entire game. It's been a frustrating performance, Jesse.
Yeah, and listen, you can't be hanging your head just yet. This game's not over. This coaching staff is still evaluating their players. So if you're on the field right now, you've got to finish this game. You've got to try to prove something to them.
Well, the game is over, to be clear. They're not coming back. But I hear what you're saying. Keep fighting. Keep showing your coaches it matters. And maybe find something positive here late that you can build on for the weeks to come.
And he'll be marked down, but he's got enough to move the chains. Wants to throw. It's Francis. Fires to the wideout. Got his man downfield. Make the stop at the 40, but he's got 15 yards on that one and a first down. He's going to pass. Caught over the middle. It's Ballard.
Well, and here's the problem offensively, because you're trailing by so much so late in the game, the defense now is going to be playing big zone coverages, and they're going to allow you to throw the ball underneath in the middle of the field, rally to make a tackle, and bleed the clock. It's going to be hard now for this offense to claw their way back in this one.
Boy, this freshman quarterback has a hose. Did he zing that thing in there? And he's just going to spike it. Sixth play of the drive coming up. Looking to throw on second down. Rush coming in hot, and they got him at the 29. Now they've got to hustle to the line and get set. On third and long, doesn't need to take the check down. It's caught downfield. They make the tackle just outside the end zone, but it'll be first and goal from the 1. The offense will use a timeout with 25 seconds left. He's looking to throw. To the end zone, and it's picked off.
This is a beautiful situation for the defense. When you're up by 2+ scores and you're in this situation, you know exactly what is coming. It's going to be a pass. They have to, because the clock is their enemy. Great job playing pass, forcing the interception, almost putting the nail in the coffin.
Winning those individual 6-second battles every play, time after time after time after time, and that leads to a victory here.
And I love when teams go out and play like it's sudden death. Like if they lose the game, their entire season is over. This game wasn't for the national championship, but you wouldn't know that watching this winning team, David. Tremendous effort and tremendous execution.
I love competitive people. I love competitive coaches. I love competitive teams that they know that their job is to go out and get a W no matter where you play. You want to play in the parking lot? We'll go meet you. Great job of this team being ready, getting the W.
That's going to do it for us from here. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.